Welkom allemaal hier op Bonaire. We zijn te gast vandaag bij Captain Dons en meer speciaal bij Technical Diving Services met Zach en Lucia. Hello, Zach.
Hi, Glenn.
Hi, Lucia.
How are you?
Hey, I'm fine. And you?
I'm well. Thanks for having us.
Yes. No problem. It was really an honor to be your guest for our vacation, our honeymoon now on Bonaire. So, guys, please tell me, who are you exactly?
Well, my name is Lucia, and I am a co-owner of Technical Diving Services here on Bonaire.
And Zach, you are the husband of Lucia?
I am. I'm the very lucky guy that gets to be married to this woman. And yes, we're both the owners of Technical Diving Services here in Bonaire.
Okay, cool. So I have a question, a few questions, of course. So how long have you been living on the island now?
It's a little bit over 4 years now for me. I think Lucia's been here just a little bit longer than I have. I moved here in October of 2017.
Okay, so Lucia, you are living more than a few years in Bonaire, I think?
Yeah, it will be 5 years in February of 2022. And it definitely feels more like 5 months than 5 years, as I've really loved my time here on this island, still finding lots to explore. But also feel like definitely a part of the community here on island.
And you met each other here on Bonaire, I think.
We did. We used to work for Bruce Bowker's Carabin. I was fortunate to work for Bruce for a little bit over 2 years. And about 1 year after I was hired there, Zach came on to staff as well. And we started flirting with each other and falling in love.
That's how things going then, of course, when you work together. When and why did you make the decision to come and live on Bonaire? Because 5 years ago you went to Bonaire, so there was probably a reason for that.
Yes, so I found myself about 5 years ago, I was living on Utila Bay Island off the coast of Honduras. And even though I love the diving there a lot, the culture was a little bit too much more of a party scene for me. And I was looking for an island in the Caribbean that had a little bit more of a laid back pace of life. And I was applying to many islands in the Caribbean and I found a job here on Bonaire.
And you, Zach, what was your reason to come to live on Bonaire, or to come for the first time to Bonaire? Because
the very first time I came to Bonaire, I actually came here on a vacation. I think it was probably about 7 months later, I decided to do a dive master internship on the island. A little bit after that, I became an instructor. I was living on St. Thomas for about 2 months. Unfortunately, the island was then hit by Hurricane Irma, and So that was the end of my time there. And I just decided to come to Bonaire because I'd already been here and I'd found a job here.
All right, cool. So now you are the owners of TDS, or Technical Diving Service, here at Captain Dons. How did you get here? Because you're not the original owners, right?
That's correct. I actually was taking technical lessons with the original owner. They decided to make a career change in their life, and when the business came up for sale, we were some of the people they had offered it to, and it just seemed like a good opportunity for us.
Okay. And you, Lucia, because you are also the owner of Technical Diving. So for you, what was the opportunity of what was the unique opportunity that you have to became the owner of TDS?
I think for me personally, I was very happy at my previous job working for Bruce. But I think if looking at my life in the next 10 years, it's something that would bring Zach and I closer as a couple. It would give us a chance to try our hands at taking the risk of owning a business and being able to explore that path in life rather than always working for other people. We knew it was going to be a big step for us, but I think that we felt confident enough that between the two of us, we could bring TDS to and grow the company as best we can.
Mm-hmm. Because Bonaire is well known for their recreational diving, but you're having a technical diving center. So guys, how do you see the evolution from recreational diving to technical diving on Bonaire?
I think that there might not be a complete evolution from recreational just to technical. I think that recreational divers will always love diving Bonaire, but I think that Bonaire might start to become more of a jump-off spot in terms of training for technical diving, as the conditions, as you can see, are quite lovely 365 days a year. Mm-hmm. And I think that it's also a beautiful destination for people developing their tech diving training, while other family members or friends are also able to do their recreational diving in the same vacation.
Mm-hmm. And for you, Zach, what was your idea, or what is your idea about the evolution in Bonaire? Because Bonaire was more recreational diving, and now it seems to be more and more like technical diving.
We are starting to see a growth in technical diving. We do have a few sites here that are very, very nice. For example, the Windjammer or the Mary Bonn up north. It is a 240-foot mast steel schooner. It's just amazing to see a ship of that size, especially here in the Caribbean, and that type of wreck. Mm-hmm. It's very unique. But also, like my wife Lucia had mentioned, Bonaire really is just excellent training grounds. Tech divers can easily find the depths that they need, all right here from shore. So it really makes it, in my opinion, a great destination to gain training and experience.
Of course, you're both technical divers. You're both rebreather divers. Zach, you have your rebreather here with us. Yes. Can you show us? What's so special on this unit?
So this was the Optima chest mount. DiveRite released it last year. They had already had an original back mount unit on the market, and this was a creation of the owner. And the thing that's so nice about it is the versatility of it. You can use it with your back mount doubles, your back mount single tank, your side mount diving. And then, of course, disassembled, the thing easily fits into your carry-on luggage, which is a huge, huge advantage over current rebreathers on the market.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about it, because normally I was also with my rebreather here on Bonaire, but it was too heavy to travel, so I have to search another solution to pack my rebreather.
Solution, Glenn. We'll just do a crossover to the chest mount Optima unit for you next time you're on Bonaire.
That's a very good idea, really. That, because I'm interested in this unit also, because like Zach told, it's a very compact set and it's very easy to travel like that. Okay. What for courses do you teach with TDS?
We teach everything from open water to advanced technical courses, even closed circuit rebreather diving. Even though we specialize in technical diving, we leave our doors open to everybody because we understand everyone had to start from somewhere. None of us just ended up as technical divers or started out as technical divers. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. That's a very important point, because the name of your company's technical diving services, but it's not only technical diving. People can also came by just for recreational diving, just to take an open water course and to start with diving. That's true?
It's very true. I teach more the recreational courses. And what I love most is giving people a really strong foundation in some of their beginner courses or even a scuba discovery dive. Because I find that if somebody feels safe from the beginning of their experience in diving, it only creates more excitement and more confidence to increase their training and to pursue various aspects in diving. And so if they can start with a feeling of safety and a feeling of really specific knowledge and skill sets, then it can only get better for them in their future of diving.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, Zach, I was in your shop yesterday and this morning also. Do you also maintenance and repairs? For example, when a holiday maker has bad luck and had some malfunction on his equipment, just normal dive equipment, but also rebreathers, can they pass by to fix it?
Yes, they can. I'm factory authorized both by Scuba Pro and DiveRight to service their regulators and equipment. But yeah, we pretty much are a one-stop service shop for divers.
All right. So when there is a problem with our equipment, everybody can jump in the shop and Zach will be there to fix it. Yeah, that's the point. All right. So maybe not an easy question, but for you, Lucia, what's a technical diver for you?
Technical diver for me is somebody who is going to certain depths and spending enough time there that they need to make decompression stops before reaching the surface. And it's just an ability to explore or to spend more time at greater depths and then enjoying the reef, doing your deco stops along your way back to the surface.
I think of a technical diver as being somebody that's wanting to dive beyond the limitations of single tank diving or traditional sport diving.
Okay, so we're on, your shop is on Captain Don's, so you're also working together with them. And how is the cooperation with Captain Don's? What can divers expect for that cooperation? Or what's the advantage for the diver when you're working together with Captain Don's?
We have a really, really great working relationship with Captain Don's. We really focus definitely on more of the courses. And then, of course, they look at providing boat dives, shore diving packages, things like that for the guests. I definitely feel by doing this, it kind of splits up responsibilities. It allows the resort to focus on what they do best and allows us to focus on what we do best, which in the end provides the best experience for the customer.
Because service and a nice experience for the customer, that's your main focus with TDS probably.
Because we are a small shop, we really spend a lot of time catering to the customer's needs in terms of scheduling courses so it works better for them, or really spending time to create good foundational skills for in our training. Whether that means extending an open water course for a few more days, then that's what we do instead of rushing through courses just to get people certified so that we can move on to the next. Mm-hmm. We really try to focus our skills in customer service and really tailoring our days to meet customer needs.
Mm-hmm. All right, that's cool. So what makes for you Bonaire so attractive for a just normal recreational diver or for a technical diver?
This is really, I think, probably one of the easiest places for most people to travel to. The island in general is a really, really safe place. For the most part, families, anybody can come here. The diving is available to all levels of divers, so that way just one person isn't excluded. And then, of course, as you can see here, our waters are just absolutely beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a blue water, of course.
Beautiful blue water, and as Bonaire is known as the shore diving capital in the world, anywhere where you can pull your car over and make a safe entry and exit into the water, the ocean is yours. You're allowed to enjoy any dive spot along the leeward side of the island. And then, of course, when winds come down a little bit during a few months out of the year, we're able to go to the windward, the east coast of Bonaire, and explore that area as well. So you get a huge sense of freedom diving on Bonaire. You can plan your day exactly how you want to. And you also have so many other facets of Bonaire to explore, whether it's kite surfing or windsurfing, going to explore a national park up north, visiting caves. There's a lot more to do than only diving on Bonaire as well.
Yes, because a few days ago, we explored the East Coast together. And the conditions at that moment were extremely good. There was no wind. The waves are very low. It was a nice dive.
It was a wonderful dive, and I find even when the winds are low, there's still a higher possibility to see bigger creatures. But even if they don't present themselves, the topography on the East Coast is very different from the West side, and still it's a beautiful, beautiful display of soft and hard corals, and so it's never disappointing for me personally.
But a very important thing when you go to the East Coast and you go diving from the shore, for East Coast diving, please do it with a good guide. A guide as Lucia, for example. It was a very nice dive. It was not that easy to get into the water, but the waves are, the conditions were very, very well. So Lucia helped me a lot to get into the water. So.
Well, I think it's a kind of dive where I wouldn't recommend it to new divers. And I would definitely recommend a set of hard sole booties, as there's a lot of fire, coral, and urchins in the shallows. And then when waves are coming in at pretty steady pace, it does make for more of a difficult entry and exit. But if you have a proper briefing and you are prepared for the dive and you have enough experience, then it is a wonderful adventure to have.
Sure. I can agree that. So, the Hilma Hooker, it's a well-known wreck here on Bonaire, and divers who visit that quite a lot, the Hilma Hooker. Are there other wrecks on Bonaire to explore?
Like I had mentioned, there is the Windjammer, but that's definitely more at technical levels. Throughout Bonaire, there are a couple other small wrecks. Here at Captain Don's, we have the La Machaca, which was, I believe, one of Captain Don's boats that's now sunk on the reef out here. Same thing like the Hilma Hooker. It was purpose sunk for divers to be able to see. And then, of course, when you get over towards what used to be Cocoa Beach area, there's also a few wrecks there that sit down at about the 30-meter range.
And what's the maximum depth of the of a wreck here in Bonaire?
Windjammer sits at a depth of about 60 meters or 200 feet.
Yeah.
Most of the other ones, like the Hilma Hooker, you're looking at a max depth of about 30 meters, 100 feet.
You also have a shop, so you are representing some brands. And now you have you are an official shearwater testing center. But I suspect you represent also other brands?
We do. Like I said, we're a big fan of DiveRite's rebreathers. They're just a really, really good, simple unit. We believe in them. The owner himself and his son actually use the unit, so that right there is something that stands out as a big sign to me. And we're also a really, really big fan of X-Deep BCDs.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And also your shearwater, you're a testing center for Bonaire, or I've tried the shearwater Peregrine. I'm an absolutely really big fan of the computer. So why are you also a big fan of shearwater, of course, and why?
They really just have built a really well-built computer that seems to uphold very well. I think something else that is noteworthy of their company is most of the top rebreather manufacturers in the world use their computers for their operating systems. It's an easy product to stand behind, and I trust my life to it, essentially.
Yes. So... I'm from Belgium. Our podcast is for Belgium and the Netherlands. I was wondering, do we have many divers from Belgium and the Netherlands as a guest?
I find that we do get visitors from the Netherlands and from Belgium, more from the Netherlands than probably from Belgium itself. But Captain Don's definitely draws a bigger crowd from American tourists, and so that's mostly our biggest market. Although during COVID in 2020 and most of 2021 so far, it did, because of our relationship with the Netherlands and then Belgium being so close by, we did receive a lot more guests from the Netherlands and Belgium, as it was just a little bit easier to travel to Bonaire during this pandemic. So I think we've definitely found more of a outreach in the Netherlands, but there's definitely more room to market ourselves for the Netherlands and Belgium overall.
So, and then we came to the point of marketing. because we are doing also some diving industry marketing with the Polygon Seahorse. I was wondering, how do you think about the promotion and marketing for Bonaire? Could it be better or different, do you think?
I think that the island itself is really starting to promote Bonaire to more of the international viewers, including the Netherlands and Belgium, and selling it as a wonderful blue destination island, meaning that when you come to Bonaire, you will find that there's a lot of conservation, a lot of preserving the natural environment, from the marine park here run by Stenapa to some of our five Ramsar sites that you'll find on island. So I think that Bonaire is definitely, the island itself and Bonhata and TCB are really trying hard to promote coming to Bonaire for diving and for beyond diving as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So I think a last question, because it's getting very hot here in the sun and we make appointment to go diving in a few minutes. I have a last question. How do you see TDS evolving in the future?
Well, it's kind of interesting because we definitely bought the shop at the beginning of COVID. It was definitely a very, very hard first year. But since now that Bonaire is opening back up to tourists, we have definitely seen a very, very positive growth of our company. And I think if things keep going the way it is, we plan on making it one of the best dive shops on Bonaire.
Okay, cool. That's a nice focus for the next few months and few years. Okay, Zach, Lucia, very, very, very thankful for your cooperation for this podcast. And let's go diving for now.
All right.
Thank you so much, Glenn, for your time. Thank you.
No problem.
Thanks for having us, Glenn.
Thank you. All right, let's go diving.